All right, let's get back to the HTTP request. We need to specify some additional details that are essential before establishing the network connection. So far, the HTTP URL connection object only contains the destination we want for this request. We still need to define the action that the server should perform on the request. This is expressed using one of the HTTP verbs we described earlier, such as get or post. The next step is to make sure you set the desired HTTP method, which allows you to be explicit about what exactly you want to do with the HTTP connection. There are a few common HTTP method types or actions that you should be aware of. When we're getting information to be returned to us, the best method to use is get. There are several other methods to use in HTTP. While get is the most commonly used option, post is also frequently used when you need to update some information on a server, such as when you update a blog post, or you're entering billing information, or shopping online. In other words, a GET request is typically reading information from the server and sending it back to the client, while a POST request is generally contains information to be written to the server. Check out the lesson notes for links on where you can learn more about the various other HTTP methods. For example, when you enter a URL into a web browser, a GET request containing the destination URL is generated and sent to the server. This request also contains a header section which includes metadata about the request. This includes things like what types of languages and encodings the client can accept, and information about the client, such as the operating system and the screen dimensions. Mobile apps do the exact same thing when they're requesting information from a server. So how do you know what request method to set? Well, you can check the documentation for the given API they're using to confirm it. Each API endpoint should be explicitly documented with the HTTP action required. It should be consistent with the GET and POST behavior we explained earlier. In cases where no action is specified, GET is typically assumed. For example, let's go back to the Twitter public API. There are many endpoints provided to fetch information about users, tweets, friends, or account information. Twitter specifies upfront whether any of these endpoints are GET or POST requests. Let's click on this API endpoint, which lets us get the most recent tweets posted by a user. If I scroll down a bit, I can find the resource URL where we can make the HTTP request. And GET is the HTTP request method type because we're reading the existing tweets from the Twitter server. There are many other examples where we make GET requests to get the list of direct messages or lists of friends from a user. On the other hand, if we want to write new data to the Twitter server, we need to use a POST request. The API endpoint allows us to point to a new tweet. We have to make a connection to a new URL and specify the POST method type. Remember that if you make a POST request, you need to send the new data along as well. In this case, the message text for a new tweet. POST is used when you're writing to the server, which means you're creating, deleting, or updating an entity. This will make the new information available to other clients when they perform a GET request for the latest tweets. Here's another quick example, the Instagram API. These endpoints allow you to get information about a user or the images or video files that they recently posted or liked. All of these requests are reading information from the server, so they are all GET requests. On the other hand, the Instagram Comments API allows you to get or modify the comments on post. Here you can see the request method type is GET, POST, or DELETE. Sometimes you'll see DELETE as its own action, whereas POST will be for creating a comment. DELETE is for deleting a comment. Sometimes all of this behavior is combined in a general POST request that handles any type of modification on the server data. It just depends on how the API was built. For a list of all the API request methods, see the link below. But for the purposes of this course, we just want you to become comfortable with the distinction between GET versus POST, or reading from versus writing to the web server.